สวัสดีครับ So, do you wonder what caused many changes of our society today? We all agree that we cannot change our past, but we all can change the future. I personally believe that we can shape our destiny, we can dream. In doing so, I believe that one have to generate a possibility and start a journey. I was born in Thungkura, Rongkhai, Roet province. My parents are rice farmers. Thungkura, Rongkhai has suffered from dry land, scarceness of water supply, and the flooding in rainy seasons. But now today, Thungkura, Rongkhai has become a famous aromatic jasmine rice producing area of Thailand. In my hometown, you will see a lot of creative learning materials. For example, when you go to the rice farm, you will see small animals, for example, like frogs. The frogs can be used as a model to study developmental biology. When I was young, I used to ride buffaloes and cows. There are different kinds of buffaloes, black and white buffaloes. These buffaloes can be used also to study genetics. Of course, in this picture, you can see Bun Bang Phai or Rocket Festival. So there is cultural richness in the countryside where I live. And I'm quite passionate about learning from local surroundings. I graduated from Chulalongkorn University School of Pharmacy. So I worked as a pharmacist in the community pharmacy. I also worked as a health product consultant. A pharmacist plays a major role in developed, manufacture, and dispense medicine. Also, we give some advices to the patients to ensure the safe and effective use of the medications. In addition, pharmacists can act as the health advisors to the general public. However, many people do not realize that many health problems and chronic diseases are resulted partly from their own behaviors, their belief, and their attitudes. To be able to identify personal behavior, what caused the behaviors, we have to understand the structures and functions of the brain. I went to the UK to study my master's degree in neuroscience. When I was young, my teacher taught me that the brain stops growing and do not produce new brain cells after birth. However, recent research shows that the brain is highly plastic. The neurons can be born every day, and the brain developed the connections. Our brain, in response to behaviors, learnings, food, or activities, all the activities we perceive also influence the brain structures and the brain adaptation. I then decided to study further the brain in cellular and molecular mechanisms, and I found that not only medicine that can modulate the brain functions, exercise, that is known to be positive for the general health and well-being, also a stimulator for stem cells in the brain and the generation of new neurons in the brain. During my time in the UK, I was studying stem cell biology, lots of material for my experimental works, and also some products for my thesis. I used these materials to create the learning materials in a project that I'm going to show you from now on. But why I wanted to use my materials to use in the STEMkids project? I wanted to address several problems in Thailand. How can science be better understood by a variety of ordinary people? How can I use my experience and my passion to inspire future leaders to understand about the science and improve the health outcomes. I then decided to study about stem cells. You may have heard about stem cells on televisions, magazines, newspaper, or social media, for example, Twitter or Facebook. But what exactly stem cells? Stem cells are young cells which are not terminally differentiated. The stem cells have remarkable capacity to divide and generate new stem cells, and at the same time, they generate different cell types in the body. For example, blood stem cells generate red and white blood cells. Skin stem cells make epidermis. The brain stem cells generate new neurons. The stem cells also found in different organs. A baby begins life as a fertilized egg, which is formed by the fusion of a father's sperm and a mom's egg. The stem cells can be found not only in early human development, it can be also found in the human, the adult human, throughout life. And we all know that the stem cells not only have a responsibility to maintain the health by replacing or repairing the damaged tissue, it can also be used to treat the patients with different diseases. You may have heard that many people try to inject stem cells grown in the lab for restoring and rejuvenating the disease. Stem cells have a promise for new medical treatments. Stem cell cosmetics also make you look younger, but the technology is still controversial. The stem cell therapeutic is still developing in many countries, especially in the Western country, the UK, and the United States. But not only stem cells can be used for therapeutics, we all know that stem cells can be found in early embryo and adult humans. The stem cell treatment generates much of hope. However, the role of stem cells in maintaining health and wellness is largely ignored. The stem cell and health becoming more popular nowadays because the stem cell live in a place called stem cell niche. Humans live in a home or apartments nowadays, if you like, but the stem cells live in a small place called stem cell niche. In the stem cell home, they talk to other cell types. They receive the signals from chemicals we ingest. They are responding to the biomolecules that are cycled via the blood circulations. The stem cell also make other organs that can play important role in maintaining health and health outcome when you got a disease. There are many factors that are responsible for maintaining the stem cells to get a good quality of stem cell. For example, exercise known to be associated with general well-being is important for the function of neural stem cells. Exercise activates neural stem cells in the brain and increases the degeneration of new neurons. So this exercise makes the stem cell happy, divide, and give rise to new neurons. The new neurons are important for learning and memory. Not only exercise, the biomolecules found in foods and in traditional herbs also have some roles. All the molecules that enter to the digestive system and go to the circulatory system, they also act as a stem cell niche. They talk to stem cells and can modulate the stem cell functions. However, there are many factors that negatively affect the stem cells in your body. Alcohol, smoking cigarettes, or taking addictive drugs also negatively affect the stem cell functions. The stem cell don't like alcohol because alcohol destroys the stem cell in the brain and other tissues and may create some problems. And also, alcohol nowadays damages not only the brain cells, they also damage other blood stem cells or circulating stem cells in the blood vessels that can lead to the dysfunction of stem cells and the formation of the disease. We all know that the stem cell play an important role in tissue development. We already teach our kids that drinking alcohol, smoking cigarettes, or taking addictive drugs are not good for health. But the number of the young students who drink, who smoke are still high. So we need to find solutions how we can improve the general health, how we can find alternative approach to engage with the young students to lead their healthier life. During my time in the UK, I'm not only study the PhD in stem cell, I also happy, I was very happy and fortunate to learn about the concepts of multidisciplinary approaches, for example, the public health engagement, the social marketing, or the public health branding. So all the multidisciplinary concepts can be formulated to deliver the stem cell educations and to engage the young students to learn about stem cells and to lead their healthier life. STEMkids aim to promote awareness of the stem cells in human development. STEMkids also aim at other key stakeholders. Our aim is to promote not only the awareness of the importance of the stem cell, we want to address several problems in our society. On one hand, how to make the stem cell happy? We need to feed the stem cell with good foods. We need to make them feel happy by learning new things. We need to encourage the stem cell to function properly by exercise regularly. But on the other hand, many factors destroy the stem cells in the body. As I said, alcohol, drugs, smoking, all damage the tissue, and of course, stem cell in the body. We have other key stakeholders, not only the student. We also emphasize key stakeholders who influence the school community. For example, teachers, parents, communities, and consumers. A pilot project at Pathamnak Songkulap School shows very impressive progress. The kids learn about stem cells. They gain insights about stem cell science. Moreover, they learn about the important role of stem cells in health and disease. They told their parents to learn about stem cell and their relationship between stem cell, health, and also they learn about the politics of the stem cells. We emphasize the concept of cross-curricular learning. Cross-curricular learning is an effort to apply the knowledge and skills from different disciplinary approaches. For example, science, art, physical activities, mathematics. We can use all the disciplines to apply and to solve the problem simultaneously. We don't need to study each subject individually as we do in high school. We have to go to school and learn mathematics in 1 hour, and then jump to the physical activity, and then jump to the social science. We can combine all the disciplines in one classroom. We design all the classroom activities in a way that relevant to the real life. For example, we expose the student with the stem cell news, and the students in each group discuss with their classmates and discuss about the stem cell in the society, what they found in the ads or on the TV, and then they share their views on the stem cell. For example, a lot of stem cell banking or stem cell cosmetics in Thailand. So they need to learn more about the stem cell products in the market. to be able to understand the stem cells and the products, and they can judge and they can inform their parents. We not only focus on academic excellence, we also want to inspire, want to motivate and empower the kids to engage with the general public. We have many activities. We want to go to the community and talk to the parents or talk to the monks or other community members. Some students, they told the parents about the story of stem cells, about the stem cell products. This one student, she says she used to skip the breakfast. And now, when she learned about stem cells, the importance of stem cell in health and disease, she now aware that what she does, what she eats, will indirectly affect the stem cells in the body. So she now have the breakfast every morning, and she tells the parents and other community members that the stem cell not only can be used for the treatment, it can be found in the body, and also we can enhance the stem cell activities by behavioral modifications. We ultimately want to improve our stem cell educations nationally to be able to improve the science education in Thailand. By incorporating stem cell classroom activity, we also want to enhance the perception of the kid on the health promotion. The kids can lead their healthier life. They understand more the importance of stem cells. They can encourage their parents. They can encourage their peers to take action. So I have told you a little bit and tell you about the role of stem cells. The stem cell play an important role for the tissue development, from early development and mature, and also in the aging human. The stem cell play a major role in tissue homeostasis, health, and wellness. I also have built the case for translating the stem cell research findings into the stem cell education, stem cell curriculum, and also stem cell activities in high school in Thailand. We believe that the stem cell education not only influence the kids, the communities, the parents, to make them happy to learn new things, to lead their healthy life. We also want to improve our society in the long run, to make the society happier, to make the society healthier, and we need you. Thank you very much.